Hello everyone, my name is Sheikh Irfan. In this video, we will be learning water cement ratio and gel space ratio. So first, let's start with water cement ratio. See, as the name says, water cement ratio. So it will be defined as ratio of weight of water to the weight of cement. It is the ratio of weight of water added to the cement paste or concrete mix to the weight of cement in a concrete mix. And it is generally expressed in volume of water required per 50 kg of cement bag. For example, water cement ratio for a mix is 0.6. Then the amount of water or volume of water required for a 50 kg bag of cement will be 0.6 into 50, that is 30 kg. So that indicates water cement ratio. And for a concrete to be said as a good workable concrete, water cement ratio required is 0.35 to 0.40 and even higher. And note that lower the water cement ratio, higher is the compressive strength, and it's vice versa. Now let's see Duff-Abraham's law of water cement ratio. This law states that strength of a concrete mix is inversely related to the mass ratio of water to cement. It means simply strength of concrete is inversely proportional to water cement ratio. It means as the water's content will increase, the strength of concrete will decrease. This law states that more the water is added to the cement paste, lesser will be the strength. And more the dilute the cement paste is, lesser will be the strength of concrete and its vice versa. And it can also be reduced by proper compaction of concrete. If you have to add more water and you have to also achieve the strength, then you can do the compaction of concrete, and the pores in concrete will be reduced due to the compaction and strength can be improved. So the Duff-Abraham's law of water cement ratio is simple. This law will state that strength of concrete is inversely related to the mass ratio of water to cement. Why it is using mass ratio? Because we are taking the water cement ratio as weight of water to the weight of cement. Therefore, the word used here is mass ratio. Mass means nothing but weight in grams we are taking. Therefore, weight of water to the weight of cement. So therefore, this law states that the strength of concrete mix will be inversely related to this ratio. That is nothing but water cement. Now, let's see Duff-Abraham's law empirically. See, the formula for this is S is equal to A divided by B raised to WC. And WC, this WC is nothing but water cement ratio. So, here S will be the strength of concrete. This A and B are nothing but the constants. And this WC is water cement ratio. So, the strength is A divided by B raised to WC. This is the empirical equation given by Duff-Abraham. So, this was water cement ratio and Duff-Abraham's law of water cement ratio. Now, let's see gel space ratio. See, it is the ratio of volume of hydrated cement paste to the sum of volumes of hydrated cement and capillary pores. Simply, it is the ratio of volume of hydrated cement paste to the addition of this. First, the volume of hydrated cement and the capillary pores or voids present in the cement paste. And why we have to study this? Because the porosity of concrete, which governs the strength, is affected by this gel space ratio. Gel space ratio is nothing but volume of hydrated cement paste. For example, there is a cement paste. So we are taking volume, we are dividing it by the empty spaces, and empty spaces are nothing but volume of hydrated cements and capillary pores. And simply, it is the ratio of, or you can simply define it as, it is the ratio of solid products of hydration to the space available for hydration products. And this solid product is nothing but cement, and space available for hydration is nothing but empty spaces. So we can say that it is the ratio of solid is taken in the numerator and this empty spaces are taken in the denominator. So the formula of gel space ratio will be volume of gel divided by space available. And space available is nothing but volume of hydrated cement gel plus the volume of capillary pores. And it is noted that a higher water cement ratio will decrease the gel space ratio. And because of decreasing gel space ratio, there will be increased porosity. And because of increasing the porosity, it will reduce or decrease the strength of concrete. See, these are interrelated with each other. First, if the higher water cement ratio is used, the higher water cement ratio will decrease the gel space ratio. And because of the decrease in gel space ratio, there will be increased porosity. And because of the increasing porosity, it will thereby decrease the strength of concrete. So what will happen if the higher water cement ratio is used? It will simply decrease the gel space ratio. And when it increases the porosity and gel space ratio is decreased, it will increase the porosity. And because of this porosity increase, there is reduction in strength of concrete. Now, let's see the relationship between the strength and gel space ratio, which is established by Power and Brownyard. This is a relation which was given by Power and Brownyard. And what it says? It says strength is equal to 240 x raised to 3. That is, S is equal to 240 into x raised to 3 or x cube, where S is the strength of concrete and this x is nothing but gel space ratio. And note here, the strength which is obtained by Duff-Abraham law is based on water cement ratio, and it is depend on age also, age of concrete or age of cement paste. But the strength which is obtained by gel space ratio is not dependent on age. See, this relation will not depend upon the age. This relation, S is equal to 240 into x cube, will not depend upon the age. It is independent of the age. See, this gel space ratio. So strength developed by this will not depend on age also. So this was the video about water cement ratio and gel space ratio. Thank you.